All right, good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Crestwood Board of Education School Board Meeting, April 15, 2024. I call to the order the meeting, 7:04. Mr. Secretary?
Trustee Amon is here. Vice President Badun?
Here.
Madam President is not here. Trustee Fawaz?
Here.
Trustee Janoon is not here. Trustee Saba?
Here.
Trustee Williamson?
Here.
We meet quorum.
All right, thank you. At this time, we'd like to call up Yusuf Bays to do the Pledge of Allegiance. Hang on one second.
Jump.
That's awesome.
Pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic for one which stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Yusuf?
That's awesome.
You guys want to stay standing for a picture with him?
Yusuf.
Good job,
Yusuf.
Good job, buddy.
Great job.
Come on over here, Yusuf.
This is a certificate for you for thanking you to come out and read the pledge for us today, okay? Stay in here and put it in front of you so we can take a picture.
Andrea, come on in.
Closer to me?
Yep.
Right there. Perfect.
Present, smile. Right here.
All right. Thank you, Yusuf. At this time, I'd like to turn it over as a board brightener for Ms. Kayla Kolbush in regards to our drama theater.
Thank you for having us. Thank you so much. We're 2 weeks away from our opening night of our spring musical, and I wanted to give you a little update on how the theater program is doing at Crestwood. We are doing really well. So we have over 70 students a part of the production in some way, including some junior ensemble members, so some younger students from the community are part of it. When choosing this show this year, I really wanted to think about something that would challenge myself as a director. I'm actually very excited about it. This is my 20th year directing for the Crestwood Theater Program, so it's like, and I wanted something that was gonna challenge both myself, but also my students. So we chose Anastasia, which is based off of a Disney cartoon, but also based off of real history, which was important to me to get to teach the students about what has happened in the world. And it's a more traditional musical. So you're gonna hear them singing in a way they haven't in a long time. You're gonna see them dancing in a way they've never learned how. And it's something I'm really, really proud of because they're rising to the challenge. I'm really excited about it. Also very proud, we have 16 Crestwood Theater alumni who have come back to take on volunteer adult roles within the program, including the choreographer and the music director. And I also chose the show just because of history. Honoring what's happened in the past, teaching our students, but also being able to connect to what's happening now. One challenge that we're also taking on is for the first time, the Crestwood Theater program is going to be utilizing Broadway projections, a projection system. So we have licensed, thanks to the CCEF and an awarded grant, our projections. We are still working on raising the money towards renting the projector that can actually make those happen. So we're confident that that is going to happen, but you would not believe how expensive that is. But in terms of history, we've talked a lot about what's happened in the past to these Russian people, but also what's happening in today's world. And the entire cast and crew talked about how it was important to them to use this show to honor what's happening in the world today. Because of that, we're gonna be having a lot of like educational materials in the lobby to learn about the past history, but also what's going on in the world today. as well as we're going to be raising money for refugees that have come to the United States to seek asylum. So one way that you could really support our program is just by coming to see the show and helping us to raise money for that cause. If you guys want to get into your spots, do you want to stay behind them?
Well, I'm going to go up there if they're facing that
way. They're going to face this way, yes. So the song, you guys can get in your spots. The song they're going to be doing is called Stay, I Pray You. And in this song, they are a group of Russian people who have been persecuted and forced to leave their home. And this is the last moment before they are forced to leave, like the only place they've known as a home. And they are singing about how much they love it and how much they're going to miss it. And this is something that means a lot to them, especially because they know there's a lot of people in the world right now that are feeling the same thing. So they really told me they wanted to honor people by that. So this is the song. It's called Stay, I Pray You. And I hope you enjoy. Thank you. So our shows are April 27th at 7 p.m., April 28th, which is a Sunday matinee at 3 p.m., and then May 3rd and 4th at 7 p.m. You can get tickets from crestwoodtheater.com or at the door. And this is an entirely kid and family-friendly show, so everyone is invited, and we'd really love to see you there and support our great community and our theater program. So thank you.
Special thanks to the Crestwood Drama production. That was awesome. Great song choice as well. Very fitting. Thank you. At this time, Mr. Secretary, consent agenda.
Recommended action. Board of Education approval is recommended for the items listed on the consent agenda, which include the April 15, 2024 board agenda, the minutes from the study session on Monday, March 4th, 2024, the minutes from the regular meeting on Monday, March 4th, 2024, the minutes from the special meeting on Monday, March 18th, 2024, and the check register dated March 1st through March 31st, 2024.
Support. Support. At this time, we have a consent agenda motion by Trustee Amon, supported by Vice President Baydoun. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Thank you, Secretary Amon. Now we have election of officers. It's open up for a nomination for treasurer.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Williamson.
I would like to nominate Najah Jaydoun. Sorry. As treasurer.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion on the floor by Trustee Williamson, supported by Trustee Amon, to nominate Najah Jaydoun for treasurer. Any discussion?
Does anyone have her consent?
Yes.
Okay.
All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Congratulations, Ms. Jaydoun. You are now the new treasurer. All right, business report, Dr. Masalam.
Thank you, Mr. Vice President, acting president for this board meeting. So we have four action items, no informational items. The first action item is approval of 2023-2024 requisitions. The attached list of requisitions are items that buildings or departments would like to purchase for their upcoming needs. The requisitions have gone through all the appropriate approval processes and have been approved by administration for purchase. In addition, there are funds available to make these purchases. Once the requisitions are approved, they will be processed and purchase orders will be sent out.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Williamson.
I'd like to recommend that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the requisitions per attachment 5A1.
Support.
All right, I have a motion on the floor by Trustee Williamson, supported by Trustee Amon, that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the requisitions as per attachment 581. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carried.
Thank you. Second item, approval of confirming purchase orders. The attached confirming purchase orders are items that needed to be processed prior to the board approval. The items are staff reimbursements, maintenance repairs, and other miscellaneous items.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Williamson.
I recommend that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the confirming purchase orders per attachment 5A2.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion by Trustee Williamson, supported by Trustee Amon, that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the confirming purchase orders as per attachment 5A2. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you. Third item, approval of out-of-state field trip, Riverside Middle School. Riverside Middle School would like to take the eighth grade students on an end-of-year trip to Cedar Point in Sandusky, Ohio. There will be approximately 150 students attending this trip.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Fawaz.
I recommend that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the out-of-state field trip to Sandusky, Ohio for Riverside Middle School eighth grade students, see attachment 5A3.
Support.
All right, I have a motion on the floor by Trustee Fawaz, supported by Trustee Amon, that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the out-of-state field trip to Sandusky, Ohio for Riverside Middle School 8th grade students, the attachment 5A3. Any discussion? Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Fourth and final item, award of RFB 24001 cameras. Crestwood Administration has reviewed the proposal submitted for district-wide camera installation and will be recommending Delta Network Services. The proposal submitted met or exceeded all the specifications stated in the RFB. Delta Network Services is an authorized reseller of the products we require. They are proficient in installation and support of camera, servers, and software. The district has worked with Delta Network Services for various projects in the past. I have attached the initial bid comparison worksheet.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Williamson.
I recommend that the Crestwood Board of Education award Delta Network Services RFB 24-001 cameras.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion by Trustee Williamson, supported by Trustee Sabaw, that the Crestwood Board of Education award Delta Network Services RFB 24-001 cameras. Any discussion? Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carried.
Thank you, Mr. Vice President.
All right, personnel report.
Ms. O'Hara? Three non-instructional appointments, the appointment of a kitchen assistant at Hillcrest, Bez Hennabi, appointment of a custodian at Highview, Stacy Greenwell, and appointment of a custodian at Crestwood High School, Fatiha Stitu.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Williamson.
I recommend that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the hiring of candidates named in action items 6A1, 6A2, 6A3, effective pending acceptable criminal background check and other employment documentation as required by law.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion by Trustee Williamson, supported by Trustee Amon, for the Crestwood Board of Education approve the hiring of the candidates named in action item 6A1, 6A2, 6A3, effective pending acceptable criminal background check and other employment documentation as required by law. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
I have spring coaching appointments next. These were coaches that weren't filled when the initial spring coaches came to the board. Tracy Bezek, assistant girls tennis coach, Lena Abbas, assistant girls track coach, Demi Rodriguez, assistant softball coach, and Nuri Flowers, middle school track and field coach.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Williamson.
I recommend that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the hiring of spring coaches for the 23-24 school year.
Support.
I have a motion by Trustee Williamson, supported by Trustee Amon, that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the hiring of spring coaches for the 23-24 school year. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Motion carries.
Two change in classifications, Abir Buckley from kitchen assistant at Hillcrest to kitchen manager, and Amanda Frazier from a CHS custodian to a substitute custodian.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Fawaz.
I recommend that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the change in classification for action item CC1 and 6C2.
Support.
I have a motion by Trustee Fawaz, supported by Trustee Williamson, that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the change in classification for action item 6C1 and 6C2. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
And the final item is a leave of absence request for Suzanne Badoon. Ms. Badoon, a mathematics teacher at Riverside Middle School, is requesting a one-year unpaid maternity leave of absence beginning April 24, 2024.
Mr. Chair.
Trustee Williamson.
I recommend that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the leave of absence request for Suzanne Badoon.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion on the floor by Trustee Williamson, supported by Trustee Amon, that the Crestwood Board of Education approve the leave of absence request for Suzanne Badoon. Any discussion?
Congratulations to Ms. Badoon.
All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? And I will abstain. Roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Trustee Amon, yes. Trustee Badoon, abstain. Trustee Al-Ziyad's not here. Trustee Fawaz?
Yes.
Trustee Janoon's not here. Trustee Sabah?
Yes.
Trustee Williamson?
Yes.
Still doesn't.
Motion passes.
Yeah, you have four.
Four. Okay, with that, we will open it up to the superintendent's report.
Thank you, Mr. President. So no action items, just a few information items. First and foremost, I want to send again an Eid Mubarak message to the entire community. Hopefully it was a restful and fruitful Eid to spend time with your families. I just wanted to explain, you know, when we develop our calendar, a lot of times that question comes up. We develop our calendars usually 3 years in advance, because every 3 years we go into contract negotiations, and part of contract negotiations is establishing the school calendar. So this calendar this year was established 3 years ago. And what we do is we look ahead at and we speak to religious scholars to see when the approximate Eid would be. And we try to do the best we can to give 3 days for the Eid, because it could fall on any one of those 3 days. This year, we were in a good situation because in our school calendar, according to state law, you have to have 1,098 hours plus 181 school days in order to receive full funding according to the law. We this year had two buffer days, which means we had 183 days, which allowed us to extend the Eid holiday to Friday for the community, because our whole idea was they're going to be off Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. To have students come back on Friday, it wasn't going to be in the best interest for the community. So it worked out well. So hopefully everybody enjoyed their Eid. We are working on the calendar for the next 3 years, so we're doing the same thing again. The only difference that we're finding is that I believe in the next 2 years, the Eid may fall on either a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, or a Monday. So it'll be a little bit easier to navigate that. But the one thing we have to keep in mind is in 3 years from now, we don't only have the Eid al-Fitr for the Ramadan, but we also have the Eid for the Hajj, which are both going to fall under the school year. So we're looking at that calendar now because we understand. And a lot of times people don't realize, but the Eid for the Hajj is actually a bigger Eid. And a lot of people take that time off as well. So we're taking all that into consideration for the community, because, you know, we have to serve our constituents, and we have to make sure we put them in the best situation we can. So that's how we were able to handle this Eid this year. So hopefully everyone had a wonderful Eid. I want to congratulate the Arab Student Union. They raised $2,713 for the Palestinian Children Relief Fund. For every $2 donated, a Palestinian child or adult is able to eat a hot meal. The Arab Student Union made enough to feed more than 1,300 Palestinians in need. It's a wonderful acknowledgement. Yes. I do know right now that Sophia Beydoun here at Riverside Middle School, her and the council are putting together something as well for a next go-round, so we're looking forward to that. I believe I'm pretty sure Mr. Caseball has given them the green light, and they're putting everything together. I want to commend our students for all of their active protests and the way they've stood up, and I want to commend the community for standing up for the rights of children everywhere. So this is just who we are. Our diversity as a community is really what makes us strong. Our robotics state championship tournament. Okay, our robotics team is continuing to break records. I mean, this is awesome. Congratulations to both the JV and the varsity teams. Photobots, which is the JV team, which is basically Riverside Middle School, earned a Spirit Award for enthusiasm and excitement. Now, you don't understand, that's still a big award. And in talking to Mr. Mirabias and his team, I mean, they're so close. They're so close to building a robot that's really going to compete even further. And I think a lot of that has to do with, look, we as a school district, due to the thanks of the board, we've invested a lot in STEAM. And we had said from day one that that's going to be an area we're going to invest in. And then taking that even a step further, our Charger Robotics, which is our high school team, our varsity team, they won a judges award and qualified for the world championships. So they will be traveling to Texas very soon. The robotics team, they've fundraised over the year, because here's the nice thing. When it first happened, it was like, oh my God, how'd this happen? Nobody was ready. So we had to figure things out real quick. Now we have the mindset, we're always going to prepare to go to nationals. And they have fundraised over the last year about $26,000, which is going to help them go to nationals. We as a district, we're going to support any remaining needs and costs, but there are still other extra costs that they're asking for donations. So if you go to the robotics website, you can give donations there for that as well. So congratulations to Mr. Marabias, the entire team, truly epitomizing what we are as a district. Last item on here is we have our final potential bond community committee meeting, which is 1 week from today, April 22nd at 5:30. At this last meeting, the bond committee will identify what they would like to bring to the board as a potential bond. At this last meeting, the architects as well as the general contractors will be there to answer questions. This will then lead into our April 29th board meeting study session. Our study session will be at 5 o'clock for everyone that would like to be here on April 29th to hear what the bond committee is presenting to the board as a potential bond. From there, we will work together to identify what our next steps are. So it's been a great process. I want to reiterate, we invited about 60, 65 people for the bond committee meeting. These are individuals that are actively involved in the schools. They volunteer their time, so on and so forth. Business owners, alumni. Of the 60, 65 we've invited, we've had on average 42 to 45 committee members there at each meeting. And even the committee members that have not been able to make it, they still get the packet, they still ask questions via email, so on and so forth. So it's an exciting time, and you know, we'll have more information to come. So I want to reiterate, April 29th board meeting, 5 o'clock study session is when the bond committee, community committee, and I want to emphasize community committee, because it's community members, students, staff, they will be presenting to the Board of Education at 5 o'clock during the study session what they would like the board to consider if we move forward with a potential bond. So it's some exciting times for us as a district. Mr. Vice President, thank you for that. And I appreciate all the support the board has given this administration and the team.
Appreciate you, Dr. Masalam. Thank you to you and your team. At this time, we are at the public comment section of our meeting. Thank you, Chris.
Okay, so now that we're at public comments, sorry, I'm just getting the timer set up. This meeting of the board is held in public for the purpose of conducting the school district's business and is not to be considered a public community meeting. There is a time for public participation during the meeting as indicated in the agenda. This is not the time for debate or argument. Do not mention any student or staff names in order to permit fair allotment of time. To participants, speaker will be limited to 3 minutes. The president may extend this time to 5 minutes per person when needed. Up to a half hour is provided for public input. Direct all questions to the board president. First is Ms. Hanan Ramouni.
Good evening, Crestwood families and board members. My name is Hanan Ramouni.
Ms. Ramouni, you sent a request prior, correct, for extra time? So we will grant you, anybody who sent extra time for this particular meeting, we're granting, you were the only one, so we'll grant you extra time.
Okay. So I stand before you all today as a Palestinian American, born and raised in America. I have 4 children, 2 of them graduated from the district, they stand back there, and 2 that are still in the district. For a long time, I felt blessed to be a part of a community, knowing that we are all like-minded Arab Americans who carry the heritage with pride. Over the last couple of weeks, I've dealt with the administration that is mostly Arab American, and I would have never imagined being faced with such inconsideration for such a sensitive topic as Palestine. This topic is the topic of Palestine hits home for almost all of us. I won't go into the details, as we all have some form of social media, and we don't live under a rock. We see children like our own being murdered and starved to death. As of today, the death toll is 34,262 people, 14,000 of which are children, just like the ones standing here today. The reason I stand before you all is to express my greatest frustrations with a teacher. Since I'm not allowed to mention her name, the board has received the email that states the teacher's name. She has ill manner, and she demonstrated that on more than one occasion. Under no right does she have to take away our children's First Amendment rights by silencing them, telling them not to illustrate the Palestinian flag, ignoring topics of Palestine, and silencing them from the topic coming up in history class, and imposing her views what occupied Palestine should be called. As I stated in the email to her and to the administration being Mr. Casebolt and Dr. Masalem, didn't feel that it was important enough or considered this matter of their least concern until the situation escalated. I went into the office on Monday last week, and I was met with extreme disregard by the assistant principal, where she expressed that she didn't have to meet with me and that she wasn't going to entertain me. I was finally given less than 10 minutes to ask what steps have been taken to resolve the issue. I was told again by the assistant principal that the teacher denies these claims and that she spoke with her personally and that she was concerned because none of what was stated was true and that she doesn't even allow the students to speak about the ongoing conflict due to the sensitivity of the matter, which is a form of silencing. I proceeded to the board office to speak with Mr. Masalem, as he showed no interest in the email or the meeting. Earlier today, I met with the administration and the teacher and some staff. Collectively, the administration agreed that they didn't follow due process in handling the matter. And the teacher also admitted that she didn't follow the MDE guidelines and base the assignment off of published maps she found. In other words, the teacher went rogue to impose her bigotry. And lastly, her response was not settling. And I have asked the district to make a series of changes from within the district. The teacher could not even bring herself to say the word Palestine. She refused and continued to call them my people. We are here now, and as I have promised, this situation will not go away without change. If that means that I run for a position on board, which I am actually considering, to make sure that I advocate for these students and make sure that their voices are heard. Mr. Masalem, you just spoke about how much money you guys have collected for the students or for the families in Palestine and Gaza in particular. If there is no Gaza or if there is no Palestine, where do you plan on sending that money exactly? Do you have an answer?
Ms. Ramouni, continue with your time. That's not it. Back and forth.
I am done.
Thank you.
Next, we have Kata Ramouni.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
So, I have a bunch of kids here, and they're part of this district, and I'm proud to be part of this district. And I see great movements that you guys are doing, and I support that. And the only thing that I have a problem with is the issue of the children. When my daughter, who's a straight A student, that since she's been 10 says she wants to be an orthopedic surgeon, that tells no lies, that fasts, that prays, that helps the community, raises money, and does well, and comes home in tears because she says, I feel like, as a Palestinian American, I'm being erased. And this teacher offended her and was not sensitive to her feelings. So then when my wife just spoke, came in, and she was dismissed over and over in the emails, and the one assistant principal told her with her hand out, I'm not gonna entertain you, and turned her back and walked away. Then finally someone spoke up and she got her meeting, and it wasn't resolved. But the only thing I'm here and I'm supporting is the kids. The kids have to be heard, and you gotta be sensitive to them. You can't send, they come and they look up to these teachers, they can't be sent home crying. So there's got to be steps where everybody is aware and sensitive to the issues, and hopefully we have changed. We're not here to cause chaos. We're here to make sure the kids are heard, understood, and dealt with in a very, very protective and supportive manner. That's all I have to say.
Thank you. Thank you.
Next, we have Mr. Ahmed Fawaz.
I actually sat here and listened to them. I'm just going to change what I had to say real quickly. Yusuf, I've watched the change happen. It has been really good, and you guys, I'm very impressed. That being said, I hope this message, I'm just thinking, again, what I'm going to say now since they've said everything else. If this person that said this to these kids should pay attention, and I'm going to go a little bit into this. To a lot of us, the state of Israel doesn't exist, okay? Historically, Israel was a people, not a place. It was a name given to, and if you're going to go with the Torah, the Bible, or the Quran, it was a name given to Jacob, and his children were called the descendants of him, which was the name Israel. It wasn't a land, but 2,000 years ago, the land was given a name by the Roman Empire, right? And that name was Philistinia, Palestine, all right? I hope that this teacher can educate herself a little bit about this and not, you know, discount these kids, discount their beliefs, you know, discount their parents or their history. Right? It was wrong for her to do this, and I hope this administration has a nice, you know, conversation with her about this. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Fawaz.
Next, we have Miriam Ramouni.
Palestinian, it really hurt me when my teacher asked me to replace the name Palestine with Israel on an assignment that was assigned before spring break. Her request and comments in the past disregarded my country's existence, history, and resilience. This is something that's not only heartbreaking but frustrating because not only were my feelings not taken into consideration, but my whole heritage was being denied and diminished. When I asked her if writing Palestine on the test would be marked as wrong, she replied with a yes, which is disappointing to not only me, but every Palestinian student in this district. Essentially, she was saying that even if I put the correct answer, it would be considered as wrong. I was being told my culture and heritage did not exist. In addition, during previous lessons, my teacher would openly discuss ongoing wars in other countries, but when it came to the genocide in Palestine, she would either change the subject or not allow us to talk about it. This made me and other students feel hurt because it felt like she was trying to silence us, like we just didn't matter. Especially right now when my people are being killed in mass numbers for my people's existence to be denied here in school, it hurts more than words could describe. I wanted to have an open and honest discussion about the issue, but she didn't want to hear it. I was being silenced. On another occasion a few months ago, while I and a few other students were drawing the Palestine flag in her classroom, during passing time, she walked in and expressed her disapproval of our actions. She made it clear and stated that she did not want us to draw that flag in her classroom. Take a moment to consider a scenario where your country's existence is called into question. Put yourself in my position and imagine how it would feel.
Thank you.
Next, we have Mariam Fawaz.
Hi, so I don't think I need to explain to anyone here the importance of what's going on overseas right now and the pain a lot of students in this district are going through with the current genocide taking place. And I'd like to emphasize the word genocide because I know this board has only referred to it as a conflict. With it being Arab American Heritage Month and the month of Ramadan just passing, I want to express how absolutely disgusted I am to see racism towards Arab Americans in your middle school. So I don't think I have to reiterate what happened, as they have, but I would just like to say that every meeting, you start off with the Pledge of Allegiance. So it's time for that justice for all. Palestine was, Palestine is, and Palestine will be. There is no denying the existence, the history, and the future that is Palestine. And all of you have posted and you have talked constantly about your pain for this genocide, but it's time to put your money where your mouth is. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
And next we have Madeline, is it Bull?
Good evening and thank you for your time. I'm a concerned neighbor here in support of children's rights to a fair education and for their right to freedom of speech. I've been grateful to my public school education as a place where I learned about world history and freedom of speech, and I've been disappointed recently to learn that that right was not granted in the school district. I'm asking the board to follow Mr. Mooney's suggestions per her email to the board. The Holocaust Memorial Day Trust lists dehumanization as one of the 10 steps of genocide. We all know a genocide is actively happening, and a place of learning, such as this public school, is not somewhere where that should be ignored. Having a staff member deny the existence of a people and a country is violent and unfair to students. It is complicit in genocide by contributing to the dehumanization of a people. I hope dearly that this school district takes steps to reconcile this issue. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Really appreciate everyone speaking up. I wish we could have a lot of people in every meeting like this. Unfortunately, sometimes it takes something to happen for people to come out, but greatly appreciated everybody coming out. Just one thing before we turn it over to board comments. I know the administration is looking and doing everything they can to handle everybody's concerns. One thing I will recommend, maybe it's some type of sensitivity training for the staff or whatnot. I know they go through certain trainings, but maybe that's something we could look into. I'm not an expert in this field. I rely on Dr. Masalam and Ms. O'Hara to figure that stuff out, so I appreciate them working really hard on this matter. And I can tell you they've put in a lot of time and effort since the complaint came in, working really hard to rectify and investigate and whatnot. So your voice is heard, and thank you for coming out. With that, I'll turn it over to Trustee Saba for board comments.
Thank you. We're never to address people directly because I think it creates an expectation when people come in and give comments that they're going to have a back and forth. I only have one comment, and I'm going to break protocol to Mariam. No one can ever, will ever deny the heritage, the people, or our history. Don't ever, ever think that's going to happen, not here or anywhere in this world. So I just want to make sure you know. And to those that this is not a conflict, we know it's a genocide, and I don't want to get political here, but I'm obviously very affected. So Mariam, we will do everything we can, that I can assure you. A belated Eid Mubarak to all our Muslim community members, a belated happy Easter, and also a early happy Orthodox Easter for May 5th coming up. We want to wish all of you a joyous, it's kind of hard to celebrate for most Muslims at least right now, but a joyous time for all those that are celebrating holidays. Trustee Beydoun did talk about involvement. This is great to see all of you guys here. I've been preaching involvement for years. Someone said they're here for the kids today. Good. We're all here for the kids. There's nothing here that keeps me here besides the kids. It's that room back there full of all these students, Ayman Ramouni and all the graduates and all the younger Ramounis and all the other kids. That's why we're here. But I do want to say something, okay? Earlier in our study session, I brought this up, and I'm going to bring it up again. I love your passion, but our passion should not just be when something isn't right. Our passion should be when we're trying to do better, when we're trying to do good, and we need community support. Our passion should always be there when our kids are in athletics. We should show up to those events. When our kids are in theater or band, we should show up to those events. And I'm not saying that you don't, but I think as a community, we should all show up to support, because the tightest and closest communities are ones that support the kids. It's always about the kids. There's nothing that comes even close to being second. I'm sorry. We've got so much that we're trying to push forward here at this board to make sure that the future of our kids. I said it earlier, I'll say it again. I want my grandchildren, when my kids get married, to go to this school district. I don't want them to go anywhere else. I want this community to be theirs. But it's not going to be if we don't have this kind of support all the time. Not only when you're angry or frustrated, but also when you know you need to be a part of the solution so that we don't have problems like this, okay? I want to make sure everybody here knows nobody is disregarding anything you're saying or not hearing you. It pains us to hear this stuff. I got rid of social media a long time ago because of this stuff. Aside from that, be a part of the solution. There is a solution here, folks. The solution is to help our children grow up and be a great part of the solution nationally. And the only way to do that is to get them involved. And they're watching you because you are the example for that. Thank you.
Trustee Williamson.
I would just like to thank you all for coming out here. I also like to thank everyone for the respect and every comment everywhere today. Everybody was, you know, calm, and they say they talk to us with respect and stuff like that. I also like to comment that it was very nice that you guys didn't instantly say, fire the teacher. Every comment I heard was, talk to them, let's get this resolved. I mean, some of you may have been thinking of that, but that wasn't the first instincts, and I hate someone's lives to be ruined for one mistake like that. So I commend everybody who talked if that wasn't your first instinct. So on a lighter note, I must ask everybody to please come see Anastasia on April 27th, May 3rd and 4th, and April 28th at 3 p.m. Thank you.
Trustee Amen.
First, I'd like to wish everybody a happy belated Eid and Easter. Also, April, Autism Awareness Month, so let's not forget that. ASU has a poetry slam that they're doing to raise money for Palestine. Wednesday, the 17th, 6 p.m. at the Crestwood Library. Also, I want to thank Mr. Hassan, Haj Hassan, who's in the ASU crew, who's been doing a lot of work raising funds for Palestine. Keep it up, guys. Also, an organization I work with, Hype Athletics, just celebrated our 23rd year. I want to congratulate them for that. And then, also, like I always end with, let us not forget what's going overseas. Like Trustee Seba said, we know it's not a conflict. It is a genocide. We're going 6+ months. Numbers I have are close to over 40,000 dead, and we're losing women and children on a daily basis. I have a friend who lives in Washington, D.C., just lost 82 family members in the last 2 weeks. 82. Half of his family is almost gone. So it's something that we need to pay close attention to. We're praying for them every day. Everything we can do, we should be doing. We should always be speaking up for them. Like a friend of mine said, Khalid Beydoun, never stop talking. Always keep speaking. That's it. That's all I have.
Thank you. Trustee Fawaz.
Good evening. Thank you. So happy Easter. Happy Eid to all. Congratulations to the ASU, our robotics team, and looking forward to the Anastasia play. So hopefully we all make it out to that. Also, congratulations to RMS girls soccer team. We're winning both games now so far, shutting out both times, so very nice job there. And the bond, as Dr. Musalam was talking about, it would be, I think, really beneficial for our community next week to participate in the meeting,
two weeks,
to be able to actually see what they're proposing is going to be spent on and what concerns we actually have.
So the district is going to list them on the website, right, or send a district-wide email. And just to end with, it's really good to see everyone's participation here. I'm really sorry that this, that Mariam had to go through this, and that her parents actually, have to actually deal with all of this. Nobody really should. But it's good to see that the community came together to show their support and be here for each other. So thank you for that. And, I'm sure we'll get follow-up at least on resolution and the family. So thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Fawaz. So, of course, I get to go last. Happy holidays to all, especially, holidays that just passed and the upcoming holidays, for sure. Congratulations. I mimic everybody's comments, robotics. Dr. Masalam touched on the first ever Amity Club Junior here at Riverside. I know they're working on a Raven Day that the proceeds will go to humanitarian relief. So congratulations to them on that. Awesome watching the drama club today. It's always a treat. The one thing I will say is, thank you to the students that were able to speak up today and let their voices be heard. We know the parents are always going to support their children whenever they should. That's great. But it takes the kids to really step up and get to their parents or get to the administration or whatever happened in this case. And, I commend them for that. This special generation, I see it a little bit different than when I grew up. I do see a lot of independence and I see a lot of leadership to where we might have lacked in years past. Or it's just different, right? And it's just viewed different. So I just want to say congratulations to them for coming up here, speaking up here. I know it's not easy to speak up here, and you came up here and you did it, and you were awesome. So really congratulations to everybody here. With that, I will take a motion.
Motion to adjourn.
Support.
Have a recommended motion to adjourn by Trustee Amon, supported by Trustee Williamson. Any discussion? 7:56, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Nice job.